In this video, I teach you construction and working of cockroach boilers with the animation. Okay, so I teach you such a way that you can easily understand the cockroach boiler. So, being cockroach boiler or any boiler, the main component first one is the boiler cell. Okay, that is an outer part of the boiler cell. And this boiler cell is vertical. So, one of the characteristic of the cockroach boiler is that it is the vertical boiler. Why it is vertical? Because its cell is vertical. Okay. And this upper part is the hemispherical cell and this is a cylindrical cell. Okay. So when we see this boiler cell from the top or bottom, it's looking the circular course. Okay. And at the lower part of the boiler, the grate is provided and this grate is used to putting the different fuel for a combustion purpose. So generally we use the coal, but any type of the fuel can be used with the cockroach boilers. So here the different fuel is takes place for a combustion purpose. So here we provide the one furnace. Okay. So this area is closed and this is known as the furnace. And this different fuel is enter from this fire door. Okay. And here the fuel is put in, that is a coal is put in and oil is also used, wood is also used. That is a different type of the fuel is used with the cockroach boilers. Okay. And for combustion of this fuel, we are required the air as well as the initial spark for its combustion. Okay. And when the combustion of this coal takes place, the remaining part is known as the S. Okay. So this S is collected in this S pit. Okay. And the air is supplied from this lower part of this S pit. So here the air is come and it's mixed with the coal and we initially provide the spark. So this combustion is start, and when the combustion is start, it create the some hot gases or a flue gases. So these flue gases is supplied in the fire tube. Okay, this cockroach boiler is a one type of the fire tube boiler, means the fire is inside the boiler. So this here we see that the furnace is inside the boiler, so it is also known as the internally fire boiler. Now this hot gases is supplied to this fire tub by using this flue pipe. Okay, so this is a flue pipe. Here this orange part, it is known as the combustion chambers and it is a fire brick lining. This lining is provided because of the heat is not rejected to the atmosphere. So from this is the combustion chamber, and this combustion chamber, there is a different fire tube is connected. So here we see that it is a four fire tube. So due to the multiple fire tube, there one of the characteristic of the cockroach boiler is that it is a multi fire tube. Okay. Because more than one tube is used, that's why it is known as the multi fire tube. Okay. So these gases is passing from this tube and the water is surrounding to this tube. Okay. And these flue gases coming out from this fire tube is collected in one smoke box, and this smoke box is connected with the chimney. Okay. And one door is provided on the smoke box for to easily cleaning off the smoke box. Okay. So these are the major part of the cockroach boilers, and some are the mounting is also installed. So here I show you this different mounting that is put in. Okay. So here I show you this water level inside the cockroach boiler. So first mounting is the feed check valve. The function of the feed check valve is to supply the water. Okay, so water is inlet here and the mass of the water is controlled by using this valve, and the water is coming in the inside the cockroach boiler naturally. So it is known as the natural circulated boiler, because there is a no pump is used for supplying the water. That's why it is known as the natural circulated boiler. Another part is the steam is collected on this hemispherical part of the boiler cell. Here the anti-priming pipe is provided. So what is the function of anti-priming pipe? That we understand later on. So watch the video up to the end for complete understanding of the different devices. Here I show you just overview. It is a steam stop valve. Okay, and the steam is outlet is coming out from this steam stop valve. Another it is the manhole. The manhole is generally provided for the cleaning purpose. So the man is opened this hole and going inside for the cleaning purpose. This is the pressure gauge. The pressure gauge is indicate the pressure of the steam that pressure in this hemispherical part. and here it is a dead weight safety valve. Then it is, here it is a fusible plug. So at the end of video I teach you what is the meaning of fusible plug, why it is used. It is the water level indicators. So its name is suggest that the indicators which show the water level inside the boiler, it is known as the water level indicator. And here the blow up cock. The blow up cock is generally used to emptying this boiler cell from the water. Okay, so when we need to cleaning up this boiler, at that time we remove the particular water present inside the boiler cell by opening this blow up cock, and boiler is empty and the man is going inside from this manhole for inspection either for a cleaning purpose. So this is the construction of a Cochran boilers. Okay, now before moving ahead, I request to like the video and subscribe the channels for more watching the more video. Okay, so here I show you this revise some points of this construction, how to return this point in examination. Boiler is consists of cylindrical cell, that we already show you that this part is known as the cylindrical cell. Hemispherical firebox, this is the hemispherical firebox is here, and these are the four fire tubes, and this is the chimney. The top of the cell having hemispherical shape crown as shown in this figure. Here a top portion is known as the hemispherical shape, and this hemispherical crown of the boiler give a good strain to withstand the pressure of the steam inside the boiler. Okay, thus this shape is sustain the pressure of a steam. The hemispherical shape of a furnace can withstand high heat, and it's also useful to increase the radiant heat transfer from the furnace to furnace wall. Okay, the grate is placed at the bottom of furnace. Here it is talking about this grate, that is a place at the bottom of the furnace. This is the furnace and this is the grate, and SPD is located below the grate. Okay. The furnace and the combustion chambers are connected by the short flue pipes. So this is the furnace, this is a combustion chamber. So these combustion chambers and the furnace is connected by using this flue pipe. The wall of the combustion chamber is lined with the fire bricks. So this is the combustion chamber, and the wall of the combustion chamber is covered with the fire brick lining. Okay. So next is the specifications of the boiler, means what are the dimensions. The cell diameter is 2.75 meters. Height is 5.75 meters. Heating surface area 120 meters square. Working pressure is 6.5 bar. Steam capacity is 3500 kg per hour, means the Cochran boiler is produced the 3500 kg of the steam in a 1 hour, and efficiency is 70 to 75%. Now we understand the working of Cochran boiler. So how it's work? So in a working, first step is that the water is supplied to the boiler through feed check valve. So where is the feed check valve? So here it is the feed check valve. From this valve the water is supplied into this boiler cell. Second point, the coil is introduced to the grate through the fire door. So here this fire door. So from the fire door, the fuel, that is coal, oil or wood, whatever is supplied from this fire door. What is the next step? The hot gases from the furnace enters into the combustion chamber through the flue pipe. Means here the combustion of the coil takes place. It produces the different gases, that is hot gases. It is supplied to this combustion chamber through this flue pipe. Okay, so whatever the gas is produced is supplied here, then it is entered into the combustion chamber, and from this combustion chamber these hot gases enter into the horizontal fire tubes. So here we brought the four fire tubes, but it is possible that is more than four is used. Okay, so these hot gases is just enter into these different flue gases in a different fire tubes. Okay, then after what happen here, that is the heat transfer is takes place from the flue gases. This flue gases temperature is higher, so these flue gases hit this fire tube. Okay, and this fire tube is hit the water, because water is surrounding the tubes. So first of the tube is heated and the tube is hit the water. Okay, the heat transfer takes place from the flue gases passing inside the tube to water surrounding the tubes by the convection heat transfer. The flue gases coming from the fire tube enter into the smoke box. So exhaust gases from this fire tube is come into this smoke box, and the finally discharged to the atmosphere through this chimney. The ash form is collected in the ash pit. So when the combustion of the coal is takes place, at that time the last part component known is known as the ash, and this ash is collected in the ash pit. The steam is collected through the anti-priming pipe on the top of the cell. So here the steam is collected, okay, and in the steam there is a moisture is also present. So this moisture is removed by using this anti-priming pipe, and from this anti-priming pipe the steam is supplied to the steam stop valve, and the steam out is supplied whenever the steam is required. Okay, so these are the working. Now what are the various mounting is used? So we already studying that is a steam pressure gauge here, which is used to measure the pressure. Water level indicator is used to check the water level inside the cell. Dead weight safety valve, it is used for a safety purpose when the pressure is increased. Then the dead weight is destroyed and the steam is coming out, and it avoids the blasting of the boiler. Feed check valve, the feed check valve is supplied the water to the boiler cell. Blow up cock, the blow up cock is used to empty the boiler cell for an inspection or a cleaning purpose. Steam stop valve is used to supply the steam whenever it is the required. Manhole is generally provided for the inspection or cleaning purpose. And the damper is used for the controlling the mass flow rate of the air. So it is provided here for a aspirate, for a controlling the mass flow rate of air. Next is the fusible plug. Fusible plug is used to stop firing when the water level in the boiler is lower than the safe limit. Okay. So what happened? This fusible plug is provided above the combustion chamber. So when the water level is reduced, okay, then steam is start to come on the fusible plug, and fusible plug is melt. And it's melt, then the water is start to supplying into this combustion chamber and furnace. So it stops the our combustion and stop the heating of the boiler. So it is used for a safety purpose. What is anti-priming pipe? To separate the water particles for a steam and collect the dry saturated steam. So here the steam present, it is a dry steam as well as the wet steam. Okay. So this wet particle or the water particles are removed by the anti-priming pipe, and dry and saturated steam for the boiler is supplied through the steam stop valve. Next is the advantages. It is a compact and portable boiler, so minimum floor area is required. Initial cost is less. It can be moved and set up radially in a different location easily. So quick and easy installation. Any type of the fuel can be used for a combustion. And disadvantages. Steam rising capacity is less due to vertical design, means lower steam is produced. Water along with the steam may be entering a steam pipe under heavy loads due to the small steam space. So space for the steam is lower. Third point, efficiency is poor in smaller size. Thank you for watching this video. If you learned, then like the video, subscribe the channels and share with your friends.